That sweet face, that bobbed hairstyle, and determination led her to become known as America's sweetheart. The figure skating champion of the 1976 Olympics, Dorothy Hamill, is my special guest today on this podcast.
My next guest was just 19 years old when she took home the gold in the 1976 Winter Olympics. Known for her moves on the ice and, of course, that bob hairstyle we all wanted, she was and is still the American sweetheart. Welcome to my show, Dorothy Hamill.
Thank you, Wendy.
Take us back to 1976 when you took home the gold.
Oh, boy. I was very young, and it was changed my life forever, and it didn't sink in for a long time. I'm not sure it really has even sunk in now.
Really?
Really?
Amazing, isn't it? Like, you pinch yourself, you look back, and you're like, wow, did that happen?
I know, and every once in a while I'll see the medal ceremony and the music, and it takes me right back, but it does seem like another lifetime in many ways.
What was it like training for that? What was it, and when did you first begin? Was it first, you first started skating, I think it was at 8 years old on a pond?
That's it, on a pond, 8 years old. I fell in love with it instantly and begged my mom for private lessons. And it just snowballed from there. It was where I built my little world with music and movement, and I loved twirling around, and that was my home.
And was it something that you just tried out at 8 years old? Was it just like, I'm just going to go skate, and then you knew at that moment?
Yes. We all skated on ponds in those days, and I wanted to learn how to skate backwards that first day, and I went home begging my mom for lessons, and I didn't know that I could learn to skate backwards, but...
There you did it.
And
what was the feeling when you were on the ice, when you were skating, even at that young age?
Just, I love feeling the wind and the smell of nature and just being out there alone. I loved music, so it was a sport I'm not sure it was a sport when I was doing it, but it was like dance, except that I'm not a good dancer.
So, well, you're magic on the ice. You're definitely magic on the ice. What was the training like?
Hours, 5-7 hours a day once I got into the Olympic category.
Was that even more?
Yes. Yeah, well, it ended up, it started once a week, and then it was 5 days a week, then it was 7 days a week, and then, quickly snowballed into 5, 6, 7 hours a day. But we had those compulsory figures.
So what was that?
That took a lot of time.
Did you have someone, like, making sure that you were resting, making sure that you were eating, all that kind of stuff?
Yes. My mom drove me to the rink, and my dad did it on the weekends, and my coach coached me. I only had 3 lessons a week because I practiced a lot. So I ate healthy. That was, as a kid, I did that. Now I'm trying to find new ways to do that. And I've, as you know or may not know, I've partnered with Nature's Bounty, and I'm trying to find new passions, like skating I can't really do anymore. And so I'm trying to find things that I love, because I do think that's important for people. And so I hike a little, I walk dogs a little bit. I now take vitamins, which I never did, because I'm trying to stay healthy. I'm learning to work with my health and trying to be conscious of it, and I want to inspire people to do the same thing.
Absolutely, and we have to inspire, because as we age and as we change, our bodies change. They just don't stay the same. Who were your role models back then?
My role models. Janet Lynn was my skating role model, and she was national champion, I think not world champion, and Olympic bronze medalist. So she was my role model as far as skating.
And how do you feel about all the skaters today? Do you feel like it's so different today?
Oh, it's so different. It's so different. I am amazed and in awe with their flexibility and their gymnastics, and it's really different.
And if it was you today, being that 8-year-old, do you think it would be the same?
Oh, it would have to be, because I wouldn't be able to do it, though. I would never be able to do those things. I wasn't born flexible, and so I couldn't do it.
You could do it. If you just tuned in, I'm talking to iconic gold medalist Dorothy Hamill. I mean, I watched you growing up as a little girl. You were everything. The Hamill camel, the hair. Now the hair, that was just your hair, and then all of a sudden it became this big thing. What did that mean to you?
I never got it. You know, I always had short hair, and I was trying to find a stylish haircut, and so it just sort of happened. Who knew? I mean, I never figured that people would want to have that haircut.
And everybody wanted that haircut, and you still look just as beautiful as you did back then.
Well, thank you very much.
And your book, A Skating Life.
Mm-hmm.
You were very, very open about that, about depression and many other things in that book.
Yes.
Helped a lot of people.
Well, thank you. And, you know, all those challenges, they have been challenges, and that's kind of why I'm very much into holistic health and trying to take care of my issues, you know, as far as the depression and all that, you know, getting calcium, vitamin D, sleep, you know, I take melatonin. So those are the things that I'm really trying to focus on, as opposed to having some prescription medicine. And it's the first time in many years I've really started to feel great without. And then I do, you know, other things that really make me feel better, and trying to have beauty from within.
Yes.
But finding a new love has really been hard. So, you know, I walk my dogs, and start to play a little tennis and bike a little, and, you know, I take stairs instead of elevators. I park the farthest away I can from,
you sound like
you
me
know,
now.
From the grocery store. I just, any way to get in steps, you know?
Yes, it's so important, because for such a long time, you were living this life and going and going and going, and then you have to find new ways, because we still have to keep moving.
We do. Keep moving. That's exactly one of the things that I'm really an advocate for, no matter what it is. And you know, everybody has their idea of what health is, and it may not be, you know, physical, and certainly a lot of us are not going to be doing Olympic training. So just little things, spiritually, emotionally. I take my vitamins. That's been helpful.
It's so important. And if you just know, I'm talking to Dorothy Hamill. You have a daughter.
I do.
And never pushed her to go on the ice, right?
Never. She took lessons for about 6 months, and I was, you know, I just sat there trying to bite my lip while she was learning. And the good news is she discovered that it wasn't for her. So.
And it wasn't for her. That's okay. And that's okay, right?
Yeah, exactly.
To each his own.
Yep, I've tried to expose her the way my parents did to many activities, and it's hard to. I had a passion so early in life.
So early.
That I'm very grateful for having that. But now I can't do it, even though it's still a passion. So I do think it's really important to find something you love to do.
And you did a lot. Are you still doing that ice skate?
I am not. The program is still going. I moved away from Baltimore, unfortunately. But Kennedy Krieger was just the most incredible place. And working with those youngsters was, for those who don't know what ice skate is, it's a skating program for youngsters with various spinal cord injuries.
Yes.
And autism. So they had a sled hockey program, and so I wanted them to have figure skating, because that's all I know.
Right.
So I'm hoping that I can start one there, because they have horseback riding and skiing and hockey, so I'd like to start.
I remember reading about that, and that you were doing that, and I thought that was just so wonderful to give them a chance to feel that.
Yes.
A program that allows them to, you know, take to the ice and be free, too. So that was just a wonderful thing. You've done so many great things,
been a joy.
By being open, and I know you had a brief battle with breast cancer, and mm-hmm. you're fine and healthy for that.
I am, and that's, you know, my doctors, you got to take vitamin D and calcium. Those are the things that, you know, with the cancer meds really affected me. So I'm diligent about it.
Yeah, important for us all to know. So what else is next for you besides being healthy and taking on a new, you know, staying healthy while juggling the busy lifestyle that you do?
Well, I'm, as I mentioned, I'm really trying to stay healthy and to take care of myself. So partnering with Nature's Bounty, if you want tips, come and go to the naturesbounty.com and work along with me.
Dorothy Hamill, you were always such a joy to watch and to talk to. Thank you for joining me. Iconic gold medalist. I don't even know what to say. I'm thrilled to talk to you today. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks for listening to my podcast. You can check out my new website at whatsupwithwendy.com. Subscribe and check out past interviews. You can also follow me on Instagram and Twitter at whatsupwithwendy. Thanks for tuning in.